So you think you know journal entries, do you? Let's put your knowledge to the test. I'm James, you're watching Accounting Stuff, and today I've carefully crafted 20 multiple choice questions for you. So grab a pen, play along, and remember to share your score in the comments at the end. This video is sponsored by QuickBooks Online. More on that later. Question 1. A journal entry is a record of a financial transaction, a type of financial statement, a list of account balances, or a summary of cash transactions. The answer is A. A journal entry is a record of a transaction in an accounting system. Question 2. A journal number is a reference number used to identify a journal entry, but is it random, temporary, optional, or unique? It's D. Journal numbers are unique reference numbers that help us track and identify transactions. Question 3. Which date is the date that a journal entry is recorded in the general ledger? Is it the transaction date, entry date, approval date, or posting date? D again. The posting date determines when a journal entry affects account balances. Question 4. Why should every journal entry include a description? Is it to meet tax reporting requirements, to help users understand the purpose of the transaction, to help generate a trial balance, or to post the entry to the general ledger? It's B. Journal descriptions give context and improve the audit trail by explaining why the journal was posted. Question 5. Every journal entry includes only one credit, only one debit, at least one debit and one credit, or three or more debits and credits. It's C. In double entry accounting, every journal entry affects at least two accounts. Question 6. What is a common risk associated with manual journal entries? Is it that they can be processed too quickly, that they can bypass normal system controls, that they automatically balance, or that they can't be audited? The answer is B. Manual entries can skip some automated checks, so they're prone to errors. Question 7. In modern accounting software, automatic journal entries are often created for one-off or unusual transactions, when the trial balance is generated, when a transaction is recorded through a subledger, or when financial statements are exported. It's C. Automatic journal entries are generated by an accounting system whenever a transaction flows through a subledger. Which brings me to today's sponsor, QuickBooks Online. If you've ever entered journal entries manually, you know how easy it is to make mistakes. Wrong accounts, incorrect amounts, wrong dates, duplicate entries, the list goes on. QuickBooks Online takes the pain out of all that. It's a cloud-based accounting software that makes bookkeeping simple. In QuickBooks, most journal entries are recorded automatically when you enter everyday transactions, like sending an invoice, paying a bill, or running payroll. It does all the debits and credits for you, so your books stay balanced without the hassle. But when you do need to post a manual journal entry, QuickBooks has you covered. You can select your accounts, enter the amounts, a date, a description, and attach your support. Oh, and it'll even warn you if it's not in balance. So whether you're a freelancer, an entrepreneur, or run a small business, QuickBooks Online does the heavy lifting for you, so you can focus on the things that matter. You can try out QuickBooks Online today using my link in the description to get the latest discount or a free trial. Thanks to QuickBooks for supporting my work and for sponsoring this video. Question 8. A simple journal entry involves three or more accounts, only one account, exactly two accounts, or no accounts at all. It's C. Simple journal entries only involve two accounts. Question 9. When a transaction impacts three or more accounts, it's recorded as a correcting entry, a closing entry, an adjusting entry, or a compound entry. It's D. Compound journal entries involve three or more accounts, but they still have to balance. Question 10. Which of the following transactions would not require an adjusting entry? Recording depreciation on equipment, paying a supplier in cash, recording unbilled revenue, or accruing unpaid wages? It's B. Paying a supplier is a regular cash transaction that's recorded at the time it occurs. Question 11. Which of the following errors would not require a correcting entry? Failing to record a transaction at all, recording an expense in the wrong account, recording a debit as a credit, or misstating an account balance by $50. It's A. If a transaction hasn't been recorded, we don't correct it. We record it for the first time with a normal journal entry. Question 12. The main purpose of a reversing entry is to avoid double counting revenues or expenses, to correct prior period errors, to record depreciation automatically, or to close temporary accounts. A again, reversing entries are made at the start of a new accounting period to cancel out adjusting entries from the previous period. Question 13. Once all closing entries have been posted, which accounts still have balances? Is it temporary accounts, all accounts, revenue and expense accounts, or permanent accounts? It's D. Closing entries reset temporary accounts to zero. Only permanent accounts carry their balances forward to the next accounting period. Question 14. A business issues common stock for cash. What is the journal entry? Is it debit common stock, credit cash, debit cash, credit retained earnings, debit cash, credit common stock, or debit revenue, credit cash? It's C. We debit cash to record the cash inflow, which increases assets on the balance sheet. And we credit common stock to record the new shares, which increase equity on the balance sheet. Question 15. A business receives cash from a customer to settle an outstanding account. What is the journal entry? Is it debit accounts receivable, credit cash, debit cash, credit accounts receivable, debit cash, credit revenue, or debit accounts payable, credit cash? It's B. When a customer pays off their outstanding balance, we debit cash to increase it and credit accounts receivable to reduce the amount owed. This transaction converts one asset, accounts receivable, into another asset, cash. So total assets stay the same. Question 16. A business closes its revenue account at year end. What is the journal entry? Is it debit income summary, credit revenue, debit revenue, credit income summary, debit income summary, credit expenses, or debit retained earnings, credit revenue? The answer is B. Revenue is a normal credit account, so we debit it to bring it down to zero. And we credit the income summary account. This helps us calculate net profit for the period in the income summary account before closing it to retained earnings in the balance sheet. Question 17. A business records depreciation on its equipment. What is the journal entry? Is it debit depreciation expenses, credit accumulated depreciation, debit equipment, credit depreciation expenses, debit accumulated depreciation, credit equipment, or debit depreciation expenses, credit cash. It's A. Depreciation recognizes the use or wear and tear on a fixed asset over time. We debit depreciation expenses to record the allocated cost on the income statement, and we credit accumulated depreciation, a contra asset, to reduce the equipment's book value on the balance sheet. Question 18. A customer pays in advance for a 12-month subscription. What is the initial journal entry? Is it debit unearned revenue credit cash, debit service revenue credit cash, debit accounts receivable credit revenue, or debit cash credit unearned revenue? It's D. When a customer pays for a subscription in advance, the business receives cash now, but it hasn't earned the revenue yet. So we debit cash to increase it and credit unearned or deferred revenue to record a liability on the balance sheet. Question 19. A business buys equipment and it pays part in cash and puts the rest on credit. What is the journal entry? Is it debit expenses, credit cash, credit accounts payable, debit cash, credit equipment, credit accounts payable, debit equipment, debit accounts receivable, credit cash, or debit equipment, credit cash, credit accounts payable? It's D. This is a compound journal entry because it affects three accounts. On the one hand, we debit equipment to increase assets on the balance sheet. And on the other hand, we credit cash to decrease it, and we credit accounts payable, which increases liabilities for the amount still owed. Question 20. A business mistakenly records a payment for office supplies as a marketing expense. What's the journal entry? Is it debit marketing expenses, credit office supplies, debit office supplies, credit cash, debit office supplies, credit marketing expenses, or debit marketing expenses, credit cash? It's C. This error has overstated marketing expenses and understated office supplies. To fix it, we debit office supplies to record the cost in the correct account, and credit marketing expenses to remove the amount that was incorrectly recorded there. Bonus question. A business forgets to accrue utility expenses for the month. What is the effect on the accounting equation? Liabilities are understated and equity is overstated. Assets are overstated and liabilities are understated. Assets are understated and liabilities are overstated. Or liabilities are overstated and equity is understated. It's A. When a business forgets to accrue utility expenses, both the expense and the related liability are missing. This means liabilities are understated because the obligation hasn't been recorded, and expenses are also understated, which makes net profit and therefore equity overstated. How many did you get right? Let us know your score down in the comments. But don't stop here. I've put together a full accounting quiz playlist so you can test yourself on even more topics. You can check it out right here. See you soon.